फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द साइफोनस स्टील इन टैडोफाइट्स। साइफोनस स्टील और मैड्यूलेटेड स्टील। इन साइफोनस स्टील देयर इज अ पिथ प्रेजेंट इन द सेंटर पार्ट ऑफ द स्टील व्हिच इज सराउंडेड बाय जाइलम देन फ्लोएम पेरिसाइकिल एंड एंडोडर्मिस। इन द साइफोनस स्टील a pith is present. While we were studied in our last class about the protostele, in the protostele pith was absent. So here you see the pith is present. Siphonostele is also known as the medullated stele. Siphonosteles are of two types. First one is ectophloic siphonostele, and in the ectophloic siphonostele there is a central pith which is surrounded by xylem, phloem, pericycle and endodermis. The example of ectophloic siphonostele are equisetum and osmunda. If you are talking about the origin of siphonostele, there is a general acceptance that the siphonostele has evolved from a protostele. Two theories have been proposed accounting the phylogenetic origin of the pith: intrastellar theory and extrastellar theory. In the intrastellar theory, which is supported by Woodley, Gwyn, Wogeni, Bower, Petrie and others, according to this theory, pith originated by the metamorphosis of the inner vascular elements into parenchyma. Support of this theory is furnished by a number of plants like Botrytium, Lunularia and Osmunda regalis. In these both the pteridophytes, the central region of the protostele consists of both tracheids and parenchyma cells. In the extrastellar theory, which was put forward by Jeffrey 1897-2 and 17, the pith is extrastellar in origin. According to this theory, the pith originated as a result of invasion of the cortical tissues into the stele through the leaf gaps and branch gaps in the course of phylogenetic development of the vascular plants. According to this theory, the pith is cortical in nature. Now we can see here the another second type of siphonostele, that is amphiphloic siphonostele. So here you can see the amphiphloic siphonostele, there is a pith in the center part which is surrounded by inner endodermis, then which inner pericycle, then inner phloem, xylem, then this is outer phloem, outer pericycle and outer endodermis. So in this amphiphloic siphonostele, xylem is surrounded on both sides by the phloem. So this type of stele is known as the amphiphloic siphonostele. Examples of the amphiphloic siphonosteles are Adiantum, Marshallia. On the basis of present and absent of leaf gap and leaf tress, siphonostele is divided into different types. These are cladosiphonic siphonostele. A siphonostele which has no leaf gap is termed as cladosiphonic siphonostele. So in the cladosiphonostele, leaf gaps are not found. In the phylosiphonic siphonostele, a siphonostele with gaps caused by leaf tress is termed phylosiphonic siphonostele. In this type, leaf gaps are present. And appearance of leaf gaps in the siphonostele leads to a number of modifications such as solenostele, dictyostele and eustele. In the Solino steel, among the simpler siphonostylic ferns, the leaf gaps are relatively small and do not overlap each other in the internode. Such siphonostyles are called solinostyle, for example, Meyersinia. In this type of solinostyle, leaf gaps do not overlap, such type of steel found in Meyersinia. Ectophloic solinostyle. In the ectophloic solinostyle, here there is a leaf gap is present in the steel, and this is the leaf tress due to the leaves on the rhizome. So here you can see the pith, which is surrounded by xylem, phloem, pericycle, endodermis. So here you can see a gap and leaf tress. So this type of siphonostyle is known as ectophloic solinostyle. In the amphiphloic solinostyle, xylem is surrounded both sides by phloem. So this type of steel is known as the amphiphloic solinostyle. Here you can see in the leaf gap. In the dictyostyle, steel is break down into small parts due to overlapping of the fronds emerges from the rhizome. So these types of gaps created by these fronds. So this type of broken steel is known as the meristyle. In this meristyle, the center core of xylem, which is surrounded by phloem. So this type of steel, which is formed by the leaf gaps and leaf traces, are known as the dictyostyle. Example of dictyostyle are Dryopteris teres and Palea rotundifolia. In the polycyclic steel, here you can see the two circular type of many two cycles, many vascular bundles in two circles, two or more circles. This type of steel is known as the polycyclic steel. Examples are Metonia and Pteridium. In the eustyle, another modification of the siphonostyle is seen in the internode of Cricetum. Strands, that is, they have xylem on the inside and phloem on the inside outside. Such arrangement is called a eustyle. Here the vascular system consists of collateral or bicollateral vascular strands. That is, they have xylem on the inside and phloem on the outside. Such arrangement is called a eustyle. Example is Cricetum internode. Thank you.